the tyre's done. And I am on my way.
I'm on my way.
Got my little Costa to keep me awake. Quite big Costa to keep me awake. I'm on the road. It feels so weird being in the car without the girls. Nobody's asking me questions.
In about 13 miles
about
the roundabout, take the first exit onto the A36.
That I have to try and think of answers for. Now, because I'm on holiday, I've treated myself. I know I'm doing the medical medium, but it is gluten free and it's my favourite chocolate in the world. Minero. Does it get any better than a Minero? I don't think it does. They're up there and I'm about to enjoy it on my own. I'm eating a chocolate bar on my own without the kids. No kids, sorry, you can't have any. I can't remember the last time I didn't share something that I was eating. Sorry, I'm not pulling my dress out of my skirt out of my crotch. I'm pulling it down because it's literally under my boobs, like Miss Trunchbull.
Sakamoto on what would have been his 72nd birthday on the 17th of January.
Wow.
Highlights.
Where we are in the southwest, there are loads and loads of army barracks and lots of RAF sites and things like that. And I have just seen an absolutely massive warplane fly over. They really give me the creeps, warplanes, obviously because they're warplanes, but also because they're monstrous. My favourite radio station is the old lady in there, is Classic FM. I could drive around listening to Classic FM, like, listen to that. Children, and yes, I might not have a bra on, but my boobs are not that clean. close to my waist. This is the skirt that's come up, not the boobs that have dropped down. The elasticity is not as great as it was, but it's definitely not that south. I just looked on my phone and I've got 55. That's a lot of you. I'm so pleased with that. Like, I'm so pleased. And I know that might sound like a small number in the grand scheme of YouTube, but imagine having 55 people standing in your living room listening to you talk. That's a lot of people. So I'm really happy. I just looked up. What do you get a YouTube plaque for 100 subscribers? No, you don't. You don't, is the answer to that. 100,000 subscribers. So we're at 55. I'm aiming for 100,000. Why not? Do you know what? If you don't believe in yourself, who the hell will believe in you? Yes, I will get 100,000 subscribers. Yes, I will. If I do one video a week, 100,000 subscribers, maybe that is a little bit optimistic. Yeah, that's optimistic. Let's say 10,000. Surely there's got to be 10,000 people who want to listen to me waffle and want to see waistbands this high. As Matt would say, what chest size are them trousers, kid? Leominster, which is quite famous for, is it famous for its antique shops, Mom?
Yeah.
It is. So it's famous for its antique shops, and we're going to go into the press room, which is supposed to be a really nice pub. Oh yeah, Draper's Lane. My mom said it's bustling on a Saturday, but it's quite nice coming to see it when it's not busy. And this place is where you get something called cruffins, which is a mixture between...
Oh, no, that one, that green one.
Yeah.
Oh, you got it.
It's behind me.
My dried flowers I got from there. You know, the ones on the shelf.
The orange ones.
Yeah.
Oh.
I don't know what this place does.
Yeah, so cruffins are a mixture between croissants and crumpets. But I can't have that because it's not... I don't think the medical medium would approve. So this is Lion Yard, this is like a courtyard, this is the antique job centre. Perfect.
They do have nice stuff to
go. Do they?
Hi, do you allow dogs in? Oh, brilliant. Okay, thanks.
I was thinking something like that, but that's obviously nice, not it? That. That's beautiful. That looks a bit like Cape Clear, where the boats pull in. Yeah. Mom.
No, it's not. Definitely not.
Spenny. Spenny. What do you think, Dottie? Is it out of our price range? Oh, that looks Chinese. It's the painting that looks Chinese, yeah. Doesn't it? 1900. Wow. This is more of an emporium, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, they all are.
Oh, really? Yeah. See, I need a side table that's big enough to have a plant and my lamp on it. Is there? They've got a lovely Fortnum and Mason basket, which is £48. It's not that bad, and they're nice for storing things in.
If you're in a thriller, that's what you back the murderer towards.
Yeah.
Just shot you again, the head skewered. Oh, or you could just use that.
That would probably be more effective. I love that lampshade. Why is that £40? That's nothing. Imagine how pretty that would look lit up at night.
Nick said that this is how he looks if you don't take the picture within a few seconds.
Mom, I can see straight through you. What even is it? What is that for? For what?
It's a reach around. You're like at a cinema and you want to...
Do you know what a reach around is? I've just seen this cabinet, which is exactly the same as the one that we've got at home, our TV cabinet. I found it on the side of the road by my dad's old house in Birmingham. Someone was just throwing it out, so I picked it up about 6 years ago. And put it into the back of my Mini and took it home. It's the exact same one. Look how much it's being sold for. £895. An Urquhart sideboard. And it's 1960. And someone was just throwing it out. So we're back at my mum's now and I'm just freshening up because we're going for, we're going for a curry. Are you just wearing the same thing? Okay, I'll do the same.
Wipe the mud off the bottom of my jeans and I'm good to go.
Wipe the mud off your jeans?
Yeah, no.
They're not gonna see that. So.
Yeah.
I'm talking to my audience.
Okay, what?
I've got to duck down. This is silly. I'm gonna put it further back. Oh, that's precarious.
No. No.
No. So, we are going for a curry at a curry house called Lelbag. It's in a place called Leominster.
We've
Weobley. We've just been to Leominster. It's in Weobley, which is a tiny little town.
Yeah.
Tiny little town. But weirdly, the people that work there are all from Birmingham. So they know how to do a good curry. We've eaten there before and it was immense. So we decided today that we're going to go again.
We'll scare them.
What are you going to order?
The works. Let's get starters.
Oh, you're really pushing the boat out.
The annoying thing is, on a Tuesday, you can have a starter, a main, and a naan or a rice or whatever.
Yeah.
For $14.95.
And it's Monday.
Yeah. No, it's on a Tuesday.
But it's Monday today.
Yeah, I know.
We've missed it by 24 hours. Doesn't matter.
We can go back tomorrow, though.
Ooh. I'm going to check my lottery ticket. Imagine if I won.
Yeah. Would we still be going for a curry or?
100%. To celebrate.
Yeah.
Right, let's do this on my little lottery app. Am I going to win the lottery? Mum, what do you think my odds are, or the odds are?
A zillion to one.
That's still not zero. Come on. Your internet's really slow here, isn't it? Why? It's never usually this slow.
Maybe we need to turn it off and on again.
No, because that video that's up, it's only uploaded 27%. And if you turn the internet off, it'll stop. It'll start again.
But why don't you just upload it at home? Why do you need to upload it here?
Because it was supposed to be go live tonight.
Oh, I see. It's important.
But I mean, the chances that... Well, it's not important, but the chances...
No, I wasn't being sarcastic.
No, I know.
Oh, okay.
But it's not, it's actually not important.
Fuck it then. You're not recording, are you?
Yeah.
No, you're not.
I am, doesn't matter though.
Don't put me on saying that. I've got a reputation, you know.
No winning matches this time. I want my money back. That's so annoying. Every time I feel like I get this gut feeling like I'm going to win and then I don't. And then I get annoyed. But I still do it.
Yeah, you've got to be in it to win it.
Yeah, you have. I said that to my dad. I said, my mum said, you've got to be in it to win it.
Did he say, how did she come up with that?
really philosophical.
Really profound.
That's exactly what he said.
Just being friendly.
You look really nice when you do that. I've already got three that grow on my chin.
I've got them on my chin.
And Matt said it's, I need to shave.
You don't need to shave.
I'll pluck them out. We need to go, it's 22 and you're doing your bloody eyeliner.
It's 22 and you're doing your bloody eyeliner. It's very bad.
And I thought I took a long time to get myself looking... half decent. Stush.
Do you remember that?
Yeah. Stush. I put a bit of gloss on my usual lip combo, considering it's the evening.
Oh, an evening look. You can tell.
Shut up.
Very glam.
I know.
You might get
my eyebrows
away.
Are looking a bit spock. Aren't they?
No.
Are you? So what are they looking then if they're not looking spot? Because the way you said no,
because when
means they are looking
earlier,
something.
I was thinking you've done them a bit differently to normal. Like they're thicker at the end.
I tried to do it thinner at the end and you didn't think to say anything.
No, why? Because I don't know if that's how you do it now. I don't know what you...
Well, why don't you just say, oh, is that how you do it now?
Are you a millennial?
No. What? Millennial are people who were born after 2000.
What are you?
I don't know, but there is a term for it.
You're a boomer.
What the hell's a boomer? That's yours?
No, it isn't. That's
cheeky
older than
me.
Me.
Oh.
people born after the war, when there was a big, like the 50s.
Oh, there was a big boom of babies.
Yeah. Big boom of babies.
Millennial. Millennials.
Generation Z, Generation X.
Oh, I think I'm Gen Z.
Yeah.
Gen Z's quite cool, I think. Oh, Gen Z. Oh, no, I'm not. I'm definitely not. What? That's 97 to 2000 and something. So,
Gen X.
I am 81 to 96. Oh, I'm a millenn- I am a millennial.
Yeah, it's a bit of a band, isn't it?
81 to 96, ages 23 to 38. Generation X is you and my mom. 39 to 54. Boomers, age 55 to 73. That is so rude.
What?
Ages 74 to 91, silent. Does that mean dead?
What?
That is rude. Silent. Gen Z, millennials, Gen X, boomers, silent. They're taking the mickey.
What do they mean, the silent?
The age? Silent, this, they definitely weren't silent.
Yeah. Winning our human rights.
Yeah. I mean, that's people who were alive during the sexual revolution and the swinging 60s and...
Yeah, second wave feminism.
Yeah. They're definitely not silent. I think the most silent generation is probably, no offence, but Generation X. And probably probably millennials. Hang on. No. Gen Z. I think millennials are the loudest, actually, because they're doing all the protests and things, aren't they, for...
Everyone's always done protests. You just didn't have social media.
No, but I mean for, like, the planet 80s. And...
Oh, yeah.
You know, the environment. The
80s, different kinds of...
Yeah.
But then the civil rights movement, 60s.
Yeah. I reckon Gen Z are going to be doing marches about AI. Because that's people aged 7 to 22. Yeah, I agree.
Okay.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay,
Cinderella.
Yeah.
You do look lovely.
Oh. Yes, I do.
Yes, you do.
Yes, I do.
Stop talking badly about one cell.
Kian, I think that's a bit dangerous. There.
It's not.
So move it a little bit closer in case you knock it off.
Yeah, go on then. That's so ugly.
It's really hard to make it menu ready.
What? Why?
Okay.
Yes. But they kept making music into the
noughties.
Yeah. Showing myself almost wrong.
Today we're going to Ross-on-Wye, which my mum said is supposed to be a really nice place now. She said the last time she went was about 15 years ago and it wasn't really like a place where people visited and had days out, but she said it's supposed to be quite nice now, so we're going there. I am just about to eat my breakfast. I've got two crumpets. I'm going to have some marmalade. And then we're going to get ready. One thing about crumpets, gluten-free crumpets, they're going to fall apart.
This is the dining room. There's Daddy. Little bench there under the, that's the stairs. Drinks cabinet. Family members. The kitchen. So yeah, it's very twinkly. It's a very old Welsh, is it Welsh? I don't know if it's Welsh. It's a very old cottage on the Wales-Herefordshire border. And that is the view from the kitchen, dining room window. And then if you look out here, that's the garden. It's huge. It goes all the way back there, and there's an orchard at the back. That's the studio, which is another, it's almost like a granny flat. It's got a kitchen, bathroom, huge living area, a mezzanine level. So yeah, this garden in the summer is top tier. This is my lovely little room when I come to stay. I'm talking to my 55 subscribers. And the dressing table. She's got some really cool, like, arty pieces, and it's very cottagey. Definitely get a lot of my style from my mom, for sure. Ignore my ugly coat ruining her aesthetic. And then here is the view. So we're all ready and we're going to an antique place. Well, it's not antique, it's a shop that sells new things that are sort of rustic looking, and it's called Bailey's, which is just outside Ross-on-Wye. So I don't think I can film in there. My mum said they're quite funny about people filming in there, but I'll let you know what it's like. Just stopped off at a place called Timothy and Birch, and it's a bloody beautiful homeware store. And cafe. What? Oh my God. This is like heaven. Oh, look at that chair. It's stunning.
This is where I got Esme's hair clips.
Yeah. Isn't it?
These jugs are lovely, aren't they?
Yeah, yoga for stiff birds. I'll need that. I want everything. Oh my God, look how cute these cups are. Oh, they're so cute. Oh, look at the egg cups. These are like your kind of...
Yeah.
I really like that one.
You've got lovely little soap as well.
I want everything. Mm-hmm. Oh, that throw looks comfy. It's like almost quilt. Mom. That's good for £69. It's huge. So nice. I love this clock. It's like a modern day cuckoo. Oh my god, there's even a cuckoo in it. I love that. I really need a clock, or we really need a clock. Just everything is so beautiful. Huge cushions. I really love these for the girls' drawers. Little hairs. They've got some on there at the moment, but they're a bit battered.
Going to Leaven, which is a new pizza place.
Which is this road?
I need to tell you about a shop that they took me to called Bailey's, which was I can't even describe how amazing it was. Look at the dog in the driver's seat.
So you know the daughter,
the spoilt daughter,
a spoilt brat, and she's with her friend. Her friend's beautiful. She looks like Hawaiian or something.
And her name's Brittany O'Grady.
They've gone on holiday together with her parents.
With the spoilt ones.
The spoilt ones. They're both horrible girls, and they've gone on holiday together. There's a brother there as well who's like on the spectrum, isn't he?
Yeah, probably.
And what's happened is the friend of the spoilt brat has been flirting with this guy
who
works there on the resort, and she keeps lying to her friend about where she's
with him.
Well, now she's slept with him.
Yeah.
And she and her friend has seen them having sex, so she's absolutely fuming because she's been sneaking out of their room at night.
She's been lying about it as well, because she says, oh, he's just like trying to hit on me.
A cool boy or something.
Yeah. Okay.
So yeah. Now she's seen them and she looked fuming. Like she feels
that girl's
pushed
been
out.
Paid to, like, her parents have paid to bring her on holiday, and so she expects her to be her little,
give her all of her attention
all the time. Are you uncomfortable?
No, I just wanted to change my sitting position.
I am back home now. My time with my mom and stepdad was absolutely amazing, and you'll see we got to spend some time with my nan at the end afterwards. She doesn't live too far from them, but well, she lives about a 10-minute drive, but I wasn't expecting to see her because she was back in Birmingham with my aunt. So it was really nice to just spend the night. We watched a series that my mom had been telling me about called The White Lotus, and It's so good. It's basically a series about a hotel called the White Lotus. It's a really like exclusive hotel. It's in all the like top destinations in the world. We watched one that I think was in Hawaii. So it's the first series that we watched. My mom's seen them all, but each series is set in a different one of the hotels, and it's about the guests that are there. But it's so good, so good. And the episodes are really short, so it's one of those ones where you're like, oh, just one more episode won't hurt, and before you know it, it's 2 o'clock in the morning and you've finished most of the series, which is what happened to me and my mom and stepdad. I've got to tell you about this shop that I went to with my mom. Hang on, let me just get this off my eyelids, because I hate when I watch a video back and I've got concealer in my eyelids. Anyway, my mum's been wanting to take me to this shop for ages. It's never been, like, it's either the weather's been, because it's, like, on the Wales-Herefordshire border where my mum lives. The weather can be quite adverse. It's just never been the right time, but she's always wanted me to go, and she wanted to take me when I wasn't with the kids. I went to stay with them, and she was like, we are going to Bailey's. It's called Bailey's. So, I know my mum's got really good taste in everything, music, food, style, homeware, everything. She's just so unbelievably cool. So I knew it would be good, but I didn't know how good. We pulled up to what looks like a barn. She was like, hey, you're gonna love it. So I was like, yeah, I know, I can't wait. When I stepped into Bailey's, it's like I had died and gone to heaven. If I had to sum my style up, it's a homeware store. So if I had to sum my style up in one shop, or the style that I love the most, it's Bailey's. It's basically, how do I even explain it? I want to say rustic, but rustic isn't the right word. I feel like rustic's overdone. And it's not rustic, it's its own style. It's like the peak of country, comfy, luxury, but not in a tacky way. Farmhouse, but that doesn't do it justice, style. It's not cheap. I say that. Me and my mum were discussing this because some of the things you pick up and think are going to be really expensive, and they're just not. It's that kind of place. Nothing isn't beautiful in there. Every single thing is beautiful, and I was so inspired by their stuff. Last night I got home and I bought a light shade from there for the dining table. It's supposed to be low hanging, but the wire that our dining room light hangs on isn't as long as it needs to be in order for it to have the same impact that it had in Bailey's. But it still looks beautiful. So I put it up, and it's the impulsiveness in me. Just because I'd put that up, and I also bought, which I'll show you, this really cute cuckoo clock. That's not from Bailey's, that's from somewhere else. Because I put those things up, I redid the whole living room. Like, I moved things around. I took pictures out of the bathroom and put them downstairs. I took pictures from downstairs and put it in the bathroom. I've moved so many things around. The girls have now got, Beau's got a bedside table. Like, I'm so impulsive. I can't wait to do things. But I'm so happy I did it, because coming down to the new room this morning was so nice. I loved it. So yeah, that leads nicely into why I'm going to IKEA. Because now, I'll just show you. Sorry, the music's a bit hectic because I've got BBC Radio 6. So this is the staircase. It's like a big, that's from Oliver Bonus. And then there's just, that's the living room down there, but there's just random like little things across there. Let me turn the music off. Beau, turn it down a second, darling. Just a second. Just pause it. So, that picture that you see there on the stairs was there. And it did look beautiful. Hello, darling.
Hi.
It did look beautiful because when these candles... So that stuff behind there wasn't there. That came off a side table that was down there. When these candles are lit, the orange in that picture was just, it looked so nice. But now I want to put like a big circular mirror there. And there's one at IKEA that I've seen that I really like. So that's now there, which I love because it kind of just draws your eye up the staircase, and when you're sat here watching TV, that's just there and it looks lovely. I then took this picture, was in the bathroom, so I took that out the bathroom, and there was a picture of like
like a it was like an old-fashioned picture of just this lady. So I put that in the bathroom and it actually looks better there. And then that arrangement that I did was down here on a console table, which is now in the girls' room. So this area, excuse the wagon, it's full of stuff, it's got to go. This area, when you walk in, now just feels a lot more spacious. And that basket I've moved over there so that everything's sort of facing in the TV direction. And then, this is the cuckoo clock. It's huge. But I want it hanging down so that it's like a centerpiece of the table. So it's kind of more like there, if that makes sense. And also I'm going to get rid of that cushion and get three cushions across that bench just so it's more comfy. Instead of having this white cable in Bailey's, they have this like, it's almost like a woven material. Where can I put you? I'll just hold you for now. No, I'll do this. Yeah, so it's kind of like a woven material. Oh, I love it. Look at it. And they have it in different colours. Like they have orange, they have blue. I think they have black. But it just looks nicer than the white wire. It wouldn't be so bad if you couldn't see it. But because I think it's supposed to be like a centrepiece, I think having the cord look nice as well, because there'll be so much of it on view, will be good. So I'm going to try and order that online. Also from Bailey's, I got, this is a spaghetti grabber. So you know when you pick up spaghetti and it all just slips off the spoon? This, if you can see it properly, the spaghetti kind of wraps around these little bits and it doesn't fall off. This was only £5.50, which I think is really good. Maybe I'm delusional. There was another one in a nicer wood.
Mama!
Yeah.
What?
The phone. Okay, I'll take the charger in the car. Yeah, there's another one in a nice, I wouldn't say it's a nicer wood, it's a different wood. It's slightly darker. It might be maple. I'm not sure what kind of wood it is, but it's a darker wood, and that one's £6.50. But that's the Bailey's logo.
Why is everything like this?
Bo, please.
No,
please. Honestly, if you're ever in Herefordshire and interiors is your thing, or you enjoy interiors, please just go in. Go on the website first, because it's a very unique style and it runs throughout the whole shop. It's the same sort of style, but it's just... I said to the lady behind the thing, if somebody said to me you could spend the whole day shopping in Harrods or spend 1 hour in Bailey's, I would go to Bailey's. Like, there's just no question. It's so nice. But anyway, I'm going to calm down now. I'm going to get on the road, because we're going to IKEA. I say we because I've got a little guest again. She got a cough. So yeah, come and say hello. So we're going to IKEA, aren't we? Maybe get some lunch at IKEA?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I want different food.
Different food? But what about the fish and chips? Or the famous meatballs. Oh. Well, that's what I'm
McDonald's!
No. Yeah, so, brilliant weekend. Bailey's was just unreal, and I want to go there every single week.